I'm just going on to that.
I thought you were just going to show me some progressive slides.
Yeah.
Progression we can just talk about.
We start with that, the Humphrey progression and then the octopus progression.
Humphrey, any of you can.
Okay.
Sirisha or somebody can.
Your mic isn't working.
Yeah, your mic's not working. Try the other one.
So probably first you can just complete the progression in the Humphreys.
Humphrey, okay, yeah. So that's the Humphrey progression, starting with the overview.
Humphreys, I'm not using.
You want to complete it?
Yeah.
The Humphrey progression? Okay, I'll complete it. Yeah. Okay, the overview in the Humphrey, as you see out there.
I'm not using Humphreys.
Yeah, okay, he's not using the Humphrey. I am using it, though I want to use an octopus, and I just came back from the octopus stall telling them, when are you going to put a chin rest? Because the machine that they have, the smaller machine, is perfect. You don't need to buy the larger machine, but they don't have a chin rest, and that's difficult for elderly people. I tried it myself just now, and it's quite all right, but maybe it could be difficult for elderly people. So to go through the overview in the Humphrey, if you look at those subsequent tests that were done apart, I think 6 months apart or 8 months apart, you actually see that the patient has progressed. You look at the PSD out there, 3.90, and then you have that's gone higher. I don't know whether it's very clear for you to see, but that is the overview that you see in the Humphrey. Then you have the change analysis of the Humphrey, which also shows you progression over time. And finally, you have the latest in the last decade, what we see is the glaucoma progression analysis, which the Humphrey has put in almost every machine. It's a significant change compared to baseline. The open triangles that you see are the first time ones which come on. The half black triangles that you see are detected again on next examination. And the black triangles actually confirm that there is progression. That's a third test that you need to do. So you basically need to do at least 3 to 4 tests to detect progression on the Humphrey, and then they give you a label like, say, likely progression. And this is the GPS summary, which looks into the baseline examinations, looks into all the indices of the Humphrey that you have. I'm not going into that because I'm sure you all are familiar with the indices. The VFI plot, which actually gives you the amount of vision which is left that the patient has. It considers the VFI bar that you see out there, the second bar, and then you have the VFI regression analysis, the current examination, and the VFI value, progression analysis symbols, which I just told you about, and the GPA alert. So these are all the things that the Humphrey GPA summary would give you when you're actually seeing progression on the Humphrey. Next, we move on to the octopus. Yeah.
Probably, I think I'll
just... Yeah, you come here.
Yeah.
The other one. Oh, that's working.
Okay. Fine. Okay. Yeah, good afternoon, friends. It's a very, very short time. I'm not mentally prepared, but I'll just try to explain whatever is possible now. So in comparison to Humphrey's, octopus is a little different, where we look at the different indices, like I have the global trend analysis. Then something very interesting is on the cluster trend analysis and the polar trend analysis. So this is the, if you all use your systems, which is attached to your Humphrey machine, it is, I mean, the octopus machine, it is pretty easy to understand. What you need is a minimum of 3 visual fields that you should have done it. And if you just go and click your progression analysis software, so all these 4 plots will be shown there. And of course, you have to buy the software separately. That is the pro version. You can buy that. And then you can see all this here. So I'll just explain you each one of it. So with this itself, I think the whole thing can be completed. So you have, this is the mean defect. That is the overall defect, how much you have the change over a period of time. So this is all the visual fields done over a period of time. So this is 2000 to 2005, the number of visual fields done. So the advantage of this is, you can see here, the bottom here. So you can select whichever you want and then see how much is the progression which is happening in the overall progression. So that is the mean defect. And this triangle here can show that whether it's an empty triangle, just to show the down arrow. So that means there's a possible progression. And you see here, what is here written is the slope. That is 1.9 decibels per year. That is the progression which is happening over a period of time. So 1.9 decibels, so that you can understand that normally what we expect is about 0.6 to 0.7. If it's something much more than that 0.7, then you can say that there is possibly that you will have to alter your management either by medication or any other means. So that is one interesting thing. And looking at the SLV means that is something like the local defect, the square root of loss variance. Again, you can see the trend, how much it is progressing from this period, that is say, for example, 2002 to 2005, how much is the progression happening? The downtrend is significantly seen, and you see that about 2.1 decibels. So if you calculate per year 2.1 decibel into number of years, so 5 years, so that means the patient is going to lose additional 10 decibels within the next 5 years' time. So you can step up your therapy. So that's the very clear indication that you have. But you can always adjust from here also, you can adjust. So this is very stable. So this is normal, this is very stable here, and then you can see the progression here. Then you have the diffuse defect. So in Humphreys, I really don't know much now, I have just forgotten that. You can see that this is the diffuse loss and that this is the local loss. So what is that you are really interested is looking at the local loss, which is much more important for your glaucoma practice. So you can look at the local loss here, and you see where exactly is the loss happening in your visual fields. Which area? Is it close to the disc? Most of the time, if you take a normal tension glaucoma patients, you can see the central area is getting more affected. If the central area is getting affected, then you can go much more aggressive in treating your patients. Just simply because we all know that the central field is the most important one. If there is a progression in the central cluster, then you go for the further treatment. So peripheral, okay, you can just be a little easy, but once you see the progression in the central area, so this is called the cluster analysis, very important for us to understand this part of it. Then coming down to this, this is the polar analysis. This is where we start saying that this is the structure function correlation. When once you look at this, this doesn't see all these straight arrows down here is the nerve fiber layer loss, the retinal nerve fiber layer loss. Many of the time when we teach the PGs or the fellows, you just see these lines here, go back and see the RNFL loss in that area. So many times the PGs may not be able to pick up the RNFL loss. So you just see this, go back, dilate the pupil, see the fundus, you can really appreciate the RNFL loss. So once you see these lines are becoming longer, that means the NFL loss is really long. And it is progressively, you can see that this is a small, within this gray zone, if it is there, that is quite okay. If it is goes beyond that, then you start seeing that how much is changing. This is the structure function correlation. So this is the advantage of having the octopus. You can just connect it to your system in your OPD. And of course, now I think even the Humphreys, they do have this facility. But in octopus, it is already an existing facility. Anything else, then we can.
Just one thing, that polar analysis, Atin, is sensitivity, what is it? What are these red?
This is all sensitivity, yes. This is the length means, more the length, that means the more the longer the RNFL loss.
Which means we need to look for RNFL loss superiorly?
Yes.
If we have something like this?
Yes. No, this is the actual. This is the inferior means inferior.
The structure is inferior, but sensitivity then must have gone superiorly?
Yeah, that's visual field loss is superior, obviously. It is this is the structure, this is the structure loss.
Where it
straight.
It is,
there is no inverse.
Always. Okay.
It is not inverse. Yeah. I'm sorry, I couldn't.
That's fine.
Which one? See, this is the. This is the. What here it is shown is the structural loss. It is depicted as a structural, where exactly is the RNFL loss here. But in the visual fields, obviously, you will see in the superior area. So it is a representation. So it's a structure where it is actually damaged. And what you see in the visual fields is just opposite, always.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yes, yes.
Thank you very much, Satyan. So I'll move on to my own talk.